Now in this day we start about grade 7 and area of composite figures about triangle. The area will be half multiplied by the base multiplied by the height, and the formula of square area will be side square. It means side multiplied by another side. Also about rectangle, area will be length times the width. About the parallelogram, the area will be base multiplied by the height. What about trapezoid? Area will be half multiplied by height times when we add base 1 and base 2. And so on. If I have about trapezoid, base 1 will be 8 and base 2 will be 6. The height is 5. Use the formula. When we use the formula, we have to add 8 and 6 will be 14, divided by 2 will be 7, 7 times 5 will be 35. Now, if I unit square, because sometimes you have centimeters, another time you have inches, whatever the meters, and we say unit square. This is about first example when we have to use a formula for any shape to get the area of any shape, if triangle or square or rectangle or parallelogram or trapezoid, as you see in this example. Now when we go on and start about the angles, do you remember all angles when we have connect two angles together, when we say about supplementary angles or we say about right angles, this so that we be complementary. Now we first shape here, we say write and solve an equation to find the value of the variable x. Now in figure A, we have to say, here we have need the value of x here. So 30 in this angle, guide me, will be also here will be 30. Why will be 30 here? Because vertically angles are equal together. So this is 30, also it will be 30. Now in this, when we have the straight line FC, you see this straight line, I can say that all this angle will be supplementary together. So I can write an equation just like that, 2x plus 80. From where we get 80? We have 50 first and we have 30 from vertically angle here, so together will give me 80. 80 add to 2x, I can get 180 degrees. Now, when we have minus 80 from this side, another side 80, we can say 2x equal to 100. Now, divided by two sides, I can get x will be 50 degrees. This is the value of the x here in this shape, and this is about how to evaluate this variable of x in this shape. Take care about supplementary angles, and we see here we have vertically and guide me 30, and this will be 30. Total will be here 180. So we write first the equation, and this is first step, we write an equation. Secondly, we have minus 80 from this side. Also, we have minus 80 from this side, and 2x will be equal to 100. Very good. Yes, now divided by two sides, because this is about property of equality. I can divide it by two sides by two, so x equal to 50, and we have get the value of x. Very good. Now we start and we go on about the shape NB. When we look at this shape, the angle will be right angle. Now we have this angle formed by 3x minus 13. Another angle, we get the degree exactly, we have 58 degrees. Okay, when we add two angles together, this get, we have to say 90, because you have right, exactly you have right angle. Now look at minus, this term would be minus 13 plus 58, this plus and this minus can be write plus 45. Why? Because minus 13 plus 58, this is say that I have to minus 13 and 5 here will be 5 in ones, and 3 minus 1 will be here we have 5 minus 1 we have 4, and this term will be 48. This is about this term will be 48, simplify in 45. Very good. 45. Now 3x as it is plus 45 get from simplify two term here. This is plus, another term will be plus, and this is minus. I get plus 45. Another side will be 90 as it is. After that, we have to say minus 40 from this side, and we have also minus 45 from another side. I can get 3x equal to 45. Very good. Now here we have 3x equal, this is the value. How to get the variable x? Only we need to have divided by 3 this side. Also I divided this side by 3, and so I out this is 3 with 3, and 45 divided by 3 I get 15, and the variable will be x equal to 15. Okay, very good. Take care about how to write angles, or how to write the equation related to these angles, and another way how to put first step to write the equation first, and after that by step to get the exactly variable here x will be 15. Very good. But in first one x will be 50 degrees, as you see and described before about supplementary angles, and here will be complementary angles together. Very good. Now we go on, and we have to see, find the area of the figure. Now when we look to this figure, I can say this is one figure, this one shape, and we have another second one here, and I see this third one. I separate and look at these are contained and composite of three shapes. First one is a piece of circle. When we see this one is a quarter circle, not complete circle, but quarter. Now how to get the area one? Area one will be equal to 1/4 multiplied by the pi, as you see. Why we say 8 multiplied by 8? Because the area of the circle is equal to pi times r square. And so this is one will be quarter of the circle. So that we see 1/4. Why? Because we need the 1/4, because the part here will be a quarter of a circle. Multiply by pi, I use 3 times 3.14 times 8 times 8. Why? Because here the side here of square will be 8, related also here will be radius. Up here will also equal together radius and radius, also here will be 8. Okay, 8 square will be 8 times 8. And when we complete here, we have to by 4 get 1, here by 4 get 2. And 2 times here will be equal to 3.14 times 16. When multiply this together, I can get 50.24 meter square, because here we speak about area. Now, also we go to the another part of the shape. Here will be also triangle. Triangle, we have said to see how multiply by the base times the height. I substitute and we see the height and the base is the same value, 8 times 8 times half. Yes, I can see this is by 2, you get 1, by 2, you get 4, 4 times 8, I get 32 meter square because area. Now, in shape part 3, I can say side times size because the area of square equal to what? Equal side square. So we have to see 8 times 8. This is we get 64. Also, we have say meter square. Now, area number 1, area number 2, area number 3, all these application about the formula of circle, area of triangle, and area of square. Very good about to do that. Secondly, we have finished area of the shape because we have composite of three sort of shapes. We have to add first one, we have 50.24 plus 32 plus 68. All these will be the result. This total 146 times 24 meter square, because here we have say about the area. Now, these three shapes are very important to see about the angles, and secondly, we see about the composite figures, how to get the area of the composite figure. Very good. And now we start on and to go for another shape. Now here the shape is, we see the prism. The prism, any base that is will be polygon. Polygon, it means the base may be triangle, the base may be rectangle, whatever four sides or five sides, whatever six sides, and go on. Now in this shape, I need to get the surface area. Surface area, it means all sides, I have six faces. Six faces for this shape. How to get the area for that? Firstly, we have to say about, to speak about the parameter. Parameter of the shape, I have length 20 centimeter, and the width will be 8 centimeter. How to get the parameter? The parameter for the base will be 2 times 20 plus 2 times the width will be 8. And we have length, as you see, 20, and width, we see, as we have 8. The base parameter will be 40 plus 16. Ones will be 6 and tens will be 5. Very good. Now when we say about lateral surface, now we have to get four faces in one step. How to do that? We say lateral surface. Lateral surface. In this, we have parameter times the height. Parameter will be 56 times the height will be 16. This one will be 16 centimeter. Multiply together, I can get 896, and we have say centimeter square because we speak about area. Now this is we have get four sides, lateral surfaces, surface here. We finish. After that, I need to check about this base 1 and another base is base 2. I need the area. How to get that? The area of two sides of two base, what I get? I get now we have two base. The two base multiply together, we have to say 320 meter square, because we have 20 times 8. This is one base. I can get 160. Now 160 centimeter square. This for one base. Base 1. When we need two base, I multiply this by 2, and we can get 320 meter and centimeter square. Add to the four faces, and we have two bases together. I can get the total will be 1,216 centimeter square. This is total of the surface about this is prism, as you see in the picture. Now, when we speak about the volume, related to the base will be the area. I find the area times the height. This will be the volume will be only multiply length times the width, this get area. Area multiplied by the height, I can get the volume of the shape here. Now L will be 20 and W as a width will be 8 and the height will be 16. These are multiplied together, get 2560 centimeter cube. Why we say cube not square? Because here will be, yes, very good, will be a cube, because we have to say about the volume. The volume will be unit in cube, because we multiply two sides for area, and third one will be the height. We have multiply three sides and we get it in centimeter cube. This is about this shape. Now we go to another shape. Only I need to say about volume, because I need only to check about length times the width and time the height. Now when we look to here, if we finish about again, we have these numbers together, multiply, we have to finish. This is the result about the volume. Yes, because the volume, we have to say area of the base times the height when we write it in words. But in letter, we have to say L times W times height. L will be for length, W for width, and height for height. L and W time together get area base. This is together get the base area, area of base, times height get the volume. This is about the volume. Now the volume will be, this is the result, 560 centimeter cube, and say take care about cube for the volume. Volume will be in unit cube. Very good to see about this figure. Now we go on also about another prism. This is the side will be 2D symmetry. When we see DM, it means D symmetry. And 1.5 decimeter and 6 decimeter, decimeter. Okay, now we say about the volume. Also the volume will be length times the width times the height, and say 2 times 1.5, this will get 3, 3 times 6 will be 18 decimeter. Also we say here, take care about cube. Very good, we say it in cube. Now another shape here, also we call prism, because the base is polygon. This sort of polygon is triangle. And how to get the volume? Now we need to say, I need the base. The area of this base will be half time the base is 10 times the height. As we say height, we say 6. Now when we see here, we need height, we say 6. Now to take care about this, I say length. I can't say here height for the triangle, and also I say this is the height for the another side. So this will be height, and this will be length for length. Look, all them are lengths, sides. Okay. Now here will be by 2 we have 1, and here by 2 we have 5. 5 times 6 we get 30. 30, this is the base, the area of the base, area of the triangle. As you see, we have triangle. Area of triangle will be get 30 centimeter square. Now this is number will multiply by this, is we have 30 times, why 30? This is the 30 is the area of the triangle, because we have half multiplied by 10 times height 6. When we simplify, it will be 30 centimeter square, and this is the base times the length. As you see, the length will be 20. Now when we multiply these numbers, we have two zeros, and 2 times 3 we get 6. This is, we say, centimeter cube. This is about the prism when we say the base is triangle. Very good to see, this is sort of example about trapezoid. When we say the base is sometimes you have triangle, sometimes we say about rectangle, and also go on maybe five sides, maybe six, or and so. Now we start for another time to go on about finishing all the pages. You see, very good one here to start about the mass in grade 7. Thanks for following, and we'll come for another time. Thanks for all, and we have a good time. Very good, very good, very good to follow math. Thanks.